News 46 is brought to you by Bees Embroidery and Garment Printing, specializing in custom and personalized decoration of gifts, garments, and more. Call 775-727-9444. News is also brought to you by J.K. Nelson Law. Call 727-9900 today for your free consultation. If you need a lawyer, you need Nelson. News 46 is also brought to you by Humana, serving the community. Please stop in at 1397 South Loop Road on the corner of Loop and Highway 160.
Tonight on News 46, a home and vehicle is destroyed by fire, and VEA donates time and money to charity. News 46 starts now.
You're watching KPVM News 46 with Deanna O'Donnell. News 46, local coverage you can count on.
A family is displaced after their home burns. It's Wednesday, December 13th. I'm Deanna O'Donnell. A young family is recovering after losing their home and belongings to a fire over the weekend.
Late Saturday morning, actually, we were dispatched for a report of a structure fire, part of a mutual aid assignment, Charleston View, which is on Tacopa Road. As we were responding, we could see a large smoke column developing in the distance. As we arrived on location, we found a fully involved single-wide family dwelling with numerous exposures, including a vehicle and some accessory buildings. Crews went into service, quickly controlled the fire. There was one patient who was assessed for smoke inhalation, but he refused medical transport.
And so, do you know how it started at this point?
The investigation is pointing out to an accidental cause, and most likely related to either an electrical issue or there was an odor of propane throughout the area.
Well, I was at work, and I was on my break, and I got a phone call saying that my house was on fire. And I instantly called my boss and let her know I had to get home, and because I knew my daughter was there.
You work at Desert View Hospital, so your daughter was at home. You're in Charleston View?
Yeah.
Tell me about that. Your daughter was home with who?
Well, she was with my mom. She was watching her while I was at work.
Mm-hmm. And so your mom called?
No, my friend Nicola did because they were on their way out. My mom and everybody out there was trying to put the fire out because it was out of control. We were worried that it was going to spread and go to the other houses out there. Like, my grandparents live out there as well.
So the fire destroyed your whole home?
It destroyed everything.
Yeah. How did it start?
I am not sure. The sheriff deputy that was out there from Inyo said it could be numerous things. They weren't 100% positive. And I told him, I said, it doesn't matter to me how it started. My house is gone. Everything's gone.
So how did your mom initially find out about the fire?
She had walked outside to take my daughter outside to play and then just seen the flames. She yelled for my husband, who was over with my brother at my grandparents' house. The house was on fire, and he came running out of the house, ran right over there, ran inside, was trying to throw my daughter's belongings outside, but they just didn't get far away from the house. Everything burnt.
You have a little girl. How old is she?
She's 2.5.
What's her name?
McKenna.
McKenna. How's she doing now?
I think that's what makes it so hard. Because she wakes up in the middle of the night and just begs me to take her home. Sorry. It's really hard.
Where are you guys at right now?
We're staying at it's on the same property at my grandma's house because they have a trailer out there as well.
Yeah. But she wants her own home, right?
Yeah. She wants her house back. She begs me to get it back.
So you have a GoFundMe page, I think, a friend of yours set up.
Yes. It's shared on a lot of the local pages.
What's the name of it?
It's Help the Tharp Family, I think. It's on GoFundMe.
Spell your last name.
T-H-A-R-P would be the name that it's under.
Okay. So if people would like to donate to that GoFundMe page, they can do that. Do you have all the clothing and toys? I know your daughter lost everything.
Yeah, there's a lot of people that have been so kind to donate stuff to my daughter. I really appreciate it.
Are you able to take any furnishings right now at this point?
No, because I have nowhere to put it. That's like a lot of people, they want to donate like a Christmas tree and all these people, they want to give all this amazing stuff. I have nowhere to put it right now. It's been really hard, but I am truly appreciative of everybody that's donated. It has been amazing. I am humbled by the amount of people that care in this town.
If you would like to donate to that family, you can contact me here at KPVM at 775-727-9400, extension 201. Valley Electric Association's Ryan Muccio presented the front branch of the Salvation Army a check yesterday in front of Smith's Supermarket on Highway 160.
We're here this morning representing Valley Electric Association and our charitable foundation to present this $1,000 check to Salvation Army to go towards their bell ringing efforts to help Pahrump families in need. We're very, very proud to be able to do this and thank everybody who's contributed to our charitable foundation, that's our employees, and also our member owners who made this happen, so thank you. So the funds, the $1,000 that we donated came from our charitable foundation. And that is a fund that is contributed by our members and also our employees. So anybody who kind of uses that Roundup program or just comes in and makes a donation towards our charitable foundation, these are the things that does in the community, and it's really an honor to be able to present this today.
The Roundup is an option that Valley Electric members have where they can round up the amount of money that they pay Valley Electric to the next dollar so that the money can go to charities.
Correct, yes, and that again goes right into our charitable foundation. It's used for things like this, and then also traditionally we pay for the power for all the senior centers in our service territory for the month of December. So there's a lot of different projects we do with that, with those funds, and this is just one great example of that.
Salvation Army is here, so we've been here for almost 20 years. We've been helping the community, the people, families that are in need, with food boxes, we help with furniture, clothing. During Christmas time, we give out toys. And the bell ringing is a fundraiser for us to be able to meet our budget to be able to help the people that are in need. The Valley Electric has partnered with us to be able to bell ring, so they'll bell ringing at the Smith and at the Walmart until 3, from 9 to 3, and they're also giving a $1,000 check, which is great because it'll help us to be able to meet our budget needs. So we're thankful to Valley Electric. We're thankful for their generosity to the Salvation Army and to the community.
Can anyone volunteer to ring bells for the Salvation Army?
Yes, anybody could volunteer for the Salvation Army to ring bells. There are groups that come, like the Interact Club, the Rotary Club, the Kiwanis, the Key Club, and different, the Moose, the Elks. There are different groups that come out and help and volunteer for the Salvation Army to ring bells. So anybody that would like to come out and help, they could come. They could call at 775-751-6181.
We've had the pleasure of bell ringing every year for you. Thank you so much for allowing us to do that. This money is going to go right back to the community?
Yes, all the money that's being donated through the kettles is being going straight back to the programs in this community, yes.
Democrat Doug Jones defeated Roy Moore in the highly anticipated Senate race yesterday in Alabama. The former prosecutor beat his opponent, who is a former judge, following a brutal campaign marked by accusations of sexual abuse and child molestation against the Republican Roy Moore. Minnesota Lieutenant Governor Tina Smith has been selected to replace Al Franken in the Senate. Smith has been appointed to a one-year term, which will conclude in January of 2019. The announcement comes following Franken's December 7th decision to resign from the office over allegations that he touched women inappropriately. Well, we'll have more with Mike Colucci right after this break.